It's easy to look at Watch Dogs Legion and assume that its upcoming multiplayer mode will be a London-flavoured GTA Online. But while it does share some minor common ground with Rockstar's Playground, Ubisoft's approach to an online urban sprawl is markedly different. Forget chaotic lobbies and opulent penthouses with 10-car garages, Watch Dogs Legion's Online is a focused co-op campaign for four friends. During a hands-on session of the multiplayer modes that will be available on March 9th, I was able to play a handful of co-op missions and sample the raid-like tactical operations. These are designed for four players, making Legion's Online a relatively small-scale affair. The co-op missions remind me a lot of Assassin's Creed Unity's approach to friendly multiplayer, in that they are effectively identical to the fare that you find in the main campaign, just redesigned with more participants in mind. Your targets, objectives, and methods remain akin to what you tackled in Legion's story, and so you'll be breaking into corporations, hacking their terminals, and running away with all their precious data. But with up to three extra players in tow, you can more effectively exploit Legion's many overlapping systems. During a quest in which I was assigned to rescue an imprisoned NPC from a construction site, my team was able to hack terminals in tandem, using multiple drones to silently infiltrate and observe from the sky. There's a thrill in taking control of a cargo drone and watching a friendly spider bot hack into a terminal, primed to drop explosives on any guard that may get a bit too close to them. Meanwhile, another player made their way through the site towards the captive NPC, guided by a fourth player using CCTV and drones as spotters. Our target could then be quickly extracted the moment our team effort hack unlocked the door. Of course, it didn't go that smoothly on the first attempt. Achieving a perfect stealth run, especially in a team, takes a few tries, but it was fun to master this multi-layer construction site puzzle. Watch Dogs Legion's multiple methods of approach also meant each attempt played out slightly differently, demonstrating the potential for replays. However, the campaign-like design will likely mean the missions are a one-and-done exercise for all but Legion's most hardcore fans. There is a PvP Spiderbot arena for up to 8 players, which is essentially Robot Wars does Quake, and thus more immediately replayable. It's a bare-bones mode, though, and feels more like a pleasant distraction than the core of Legion's Online. As such, the overall experience could be quite short-lived for many.
I think the pilot felt that one.
Even if this is a whistle-stop tour, I appreciate the craft that has gone into each of Legion's online missions. The quest chains are not particularly ambitious, but they do fulfill the DedSec Anarchy fantasy. One saw our team break into a compound, steal two bomb-rigged hatchbacks, and then race against the clock to dump them into the Thames River. It's all a bit silly, which lends well to playing with a group of friends. More interesting is each mission's approach to how players are assigned roles. There are no formal jobs or classes, but objectives will require players to split from the group to perform a task, while the remainders complete a different job. Splitting players up generates a new layer of tension and demands a higher level of coordination, which is a welcome wrinkle in the mode's otherwise straightforward mission design. This design ethos is most notable in tactical operations. These are a chain of increasingly challenging missions that effectively work as Legion's answer to raids or heists. The first one immediately splits the team into two groups, as two hacks must be activated simultaneously on opposite sides of the city. During the hack, both duos are assaulted by waves of Albion troops, making it a much tougher situation than the more casual missions. I'd have liked to have played much more of Tactical Ops, as I can already see how Legion's many systems and operator variants could be used to creatively overcome its challenges. But unfortunately, my play session, which took place at the end of January, was marred by technical problems. Constant disconnections, lag spikes, and server errors made playing difficult across all modes, and this stalled our progress in these longer, tougher challenges. If these problems are present at launch, then they will fundamentally undermine the entire experience. So I spoke to Ubisoft to find out exactly what the problems were and if they will be fixed by launch.
Some of the issues that you specifically hit were like our anti-cheat was being a little too aggressive, just to say the least. We were able to reproduce it and try to figure out what was happening. The Bally issues and some of the crashes, they've already gone. We found we were already in the process of fixing a lot of them at a more solid level, and then now we just solidified it and put it into more technical tests.
Ubisoft assured me that current technical testing is going well, but that anything game-breaking will definitely trigger a conversation about delaying the online mode. With those problems solved, I think Watch Dogs Legion's online mode achieves much of what it sets out to do. It's got enough mission variety to be more than a one-session curio, albeit certainly much less than would be required for it to become a constant mainstay in my multiplayer rotation. What it doesn't do, that I wish it did, is fully bring the systemic qualities of Watch Dogs Legion into a multiplayer environment. Play as Anyone does exist in this alternate digital London, but it's a streamlined version. You can recruit, but there's less legwork. There's no danger of permadeath, nor is there the threat of your operatives being kidnapped. These are all elements that I think would create fantastic shared stories for a co-op team. There's still support to come for Watch Dogs Legion Online. This first drop doesn't include the series' classic invasion mode, and so there's hope for the game to increase in complexity and offer more opportunities in the future. As for what we get in this first update, it's a slice of cooperative madness that could be drained faster than an English cup of tea, but one that still has enough satisfying flavours to make it worth dipping back into to raise chaos with a new gang of dead-sec cyber warriors. For more, be sure to take a look at our Watch Dogs Legion co-op gameplay video and check out our review of the single-player campaign.